I have more on the exchanges between Terrence Crawford and Earl Spence. They both were in negotiation. They were both talking about a fight, and negotiations fell down. Crawford has his perspective. Earl Spence has his perspective. And it doesn't sound like they have the same information. So Earl Spence says, I've been doing all the heavy lifting. I cleared the way for him, for Sean Porter, was semi-retired. Look at the fight Porter had before Bud, for Mella, LOL, and Kell Brook was overdone. Crawford responds, Sean Porter already lost to Kell Brook and Keith Thurman, which both was both undefeated, so you didn't do nothing that wasn't already done. Crawford goes on to say, he tells Crawford, when you spin the block, let's do something that's never been done before and make the negotiations public, since your own boss effed it, peace, and a smiley face. He goes on to say, if he was so called his own boss, then why I had to talk to Al? That's right, I couldn't talk to you because when I did, you said I had to talk to your people. You can fool your little fans that don't know who you really is, but you can't fool me. So Crawford says he wants open negotiations. That's never been done. But he also says he blames Spence's team for effing it up. He says your boss effed it up, peace. Funny thing is, Crawford tells Spence, you knew the fight wasn't going to be this year. Your ass was on vacation with your family while me and my team was trying to make the fight happen for November when you wasn't even in the gym and it was in September. Y'all was just dragging the stuff out to blame me. That's something that Earl responded to, and I posted another video, but I'll just share it just to be fair over here. Earl said, hey, it was October 2nd, and I was just my son's birthday, not a vacation. And he told Crawford, you were dragging it out because you were in negotiations with the current fight that's happening December 10th. That's what Spence said. Now, a lot of miscommunication here. And Terrence Crawford says, this dude Earl Spence is a clown. He had to get his lies together. LOL. Now he got so much to say. Crawford goes on to say, he actually posted this yesterday, 16 hours ago. This is the first tweet on the subject. And he says, I'm pretty sure if anything I said was a lie, Earl Spence would have said something. So Earl Spence came back today and said a lot. And you can see that in the video before this video. It's an 8-minute video where I go through Earl Spence's posts. So Crawford said, if I'm lying, he would have responded. So I do believe that Crawford believes what he's saying is truth. And I know Earl Spence. Earl Spence is not a liar. Earl Spence has never lied to me, and I've known him for at least 10 years, since 2012. So, yeah, 10 years. And just miscommunication, because I'm sure they each believe that they're telling the truth. It's a shame they couldn't get on the same page and knock out this fight and just make it happen, because the boxing world needs it. The fans want it. Everybody's excited about it. So Crawford also tells Spence, okay, y'all, I'm out. Yo, Earl Spence, I wish you the best in your upcoming fight, and see you later, my boy. And he put like a wink and a smiley face. And then he goes on to say, it's okay. Like I said, I've been ready since I came in the division. And all I've heard was excuses after excuses. Get a belt. You taking the easy road. I'm on the wrong side of the street. Why do I want this in a contract? And now fight next year. What's next? So Crawford makes the list of all the stuff people are telling him. Why he can't get this fight, he didn't have the belt, he took the easy road, he's on the wrong side of the street, why does he want that in the contract, and now the fight is next year. So Earl Spence, here's a response from him. He said, Earl said that he was trying to make this work, that he wanted to figure stuff out, that they wanted to work together, nothing like Crawford and Bob, you know, they're suing each other now. So Crawford tells him, yeah, I know, and that's cool, more power to you. But when I made that call and told you what was what, as a man, you didn't entertain it. When your people told you not to, now you could have pulled my card and said, let's go and see what is real, but you didn't. So two fighters, two superstars, two champions trying to hash it out and make a fight happen. Crawford is trying to make the fight happen. Spence is trying to make the fight happen. Like I said, boxing needs this. They're not afraid of each other. And there's potential for this fight happening, hopefully next year. But Like I said, a lot of things could happen. What if Spence moves up? What if one of them fights and gets injured? What if one of them fights and doesn't win? There's a lot of things that can happen in not taking the immediate fight. So stay tuned. We'll keep you guys posted. Crawford's fighting December 10th, and we'll let you know what is next for Earl Spence.
Ellie Sekback, reporting for ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Sekback, reporting.
ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Sekback, reporting.